I dread waking up in his body every morning. Because each day is just too difficult for me to face. My body hurts, and the stuff I have to go through just to have a normal day is painful on every level. And so I live in despair. At the size that I'm at now, I can still get around, but it's difficult. I feel pain in all parts of my body. And I'm exhausted all the time. My parents built an outdoor shower for me, but I can't get the water to go all over my body because I'm too big. So that doesn't work for me. And the only shower I can fit in is at my sister's place. So I have to go there to get cleaned. I'm too big for chairs, hallways, doors, bathrooms, toilets, my bed. I'm too big for bathtubs. My family has a compound here in Conroe, Texas. Basically, they're just little buildings that we purchase, and then everybody has their own little personal space. So I sleep in a building next to my sister's. And then my parents live in the bigger unit. But my life has become just one challenge after another. By the time I get to my sister's front steps, my breathing has gotten pretty bad. My muscles are burning. I feel like I'm moving a whole pile at the line of scrimmage in football, but it's just the fat on my body. But that's not even the main event yet. Getting a shower, that's like a workout by itself. I'm thankful I can still clean myself, but I can picture a time where I can no longer do that, and it's a pretty scary thought. Every part of my body is heavy, so lifting my arms to clean myself is just as hard as lifting my legs to walk. And that pain from the weight of my belly pulling down on my legs and back, it's a lot. I get anxiety about slipping over and falling. By the time I get done, but I still have to dry off and get dressed. I do it sitting down because there's no way I could stand for it. And the exertion from that can be difficult. I'm going to start sweating again. But I sweat pretty much all the time anyway. Once I'm dressed, then it's time to move on to something much happier. Something that brightens my day every day of my life. Food. Food is the highlight of my day. It always gives me something to look forward to. And when I'm cooking, I make a lot of it because I have to feed my sister's kids. But also because the more food there is, the longer I can stay in the place that food takes me to. Food is my happy place and kind of as always has been. It's been there for me ever since I was a little kid. I was born at Conroe Regional. I don't remember exact details about my weight, my height, or anything like that. I just do know my mom says I was a difficult baby. The way my mother describes it was everything was stressful for me. And I think the reason was because the household growing up was very chaotic. I have six brothers and sisters, but I'm the only one with a combination of parents that I have. So all my siblings are either half or step siblings.
You can sit at your tables and have your breakfast.
Most of the time,
my parents were unhappy parents.
And they broke up and got back together a few times. So it never felt stable.
They separated after I was born. That's when she met my sister's father, and she conceived my two little sisters, who are twins, Jessica and Megan.
So the twins have a separate dad. Even though they refer to my dad as their dad a lot of the time, he's actually their stepdad. In fact,
I remember being up there at the hospital, and I remember seeing my dad there at the window. He was waving at us, and he was showing the girls off. But their dad wasn't there. And I was just like, I don't know how to handle this. I don't know what to say.
So that was weird. But after that, when the girls came home, I had a tough time with them at first.
I guess I was just jealous of them. Jealous that they got more attention than I did.
So what I did when I felt that way is to go eat. And when I was eating something good, I could just focus on how good it tasted. And that's how I got myself to feel better.
I don't think my parents watched what I ate. I don't recall if they ever cared about how much I weighed when I was a kid, because I was neglected. I didn't understand at first. I was questioning myself, you know, do my parents love me? Do they care? Am I doing something wrong? I don't know if that contributed to how everything feels. I just know I didn't want to be around my parents when I was a young kid, because I don't know, it was just stressful.
Howdy, Bubba.
Hey.
All right, so we'll go shopping at the grocery store.
I haven't been to a grocery store on my own for 4 or 5 years. At this size, the thought of falling over in public is about enough to keep me from ever going anywhere.
Let's grab some of these.
Ooh, get those.
Cinnabons. All right, let's have.
Once I'm there, I can lean on a cart or ride in a motorized cart, but I wouldn't be able to come here without Megan.
Can you grab some bacon? A couple of them.
This one?
Yeah. Let's grab out 2 more of those.
Even though I'm living with my family basically almost for free, I don't like being dependent on other people. It makes me feel weak.
Let's grab one of each.
And as much as I love my family, and I'm grateful for them, I know that being dependent on them is part of the problem.
You want any chips?
Yeah, let's grab a couple of these.
But also because of the emotions that go along with living with my family are stressful. And as much as I appreciate their help, it's difficult.
I don't tell my family this because I don't want them feeling like they're responsible for it. Where I live today has been a big factor of increasing weight,
because a lot of my stress and anxiety comes from them.
You know, whenever they stress me out, or if they fight, or if they argue with me or something like that, I have to go and eat something, and I hate it.
Is this enough?
That'd be enough.
All right.
That'd be enough.
But hopefully that'll change. Hopefully I can take away the habit and do better coping,
because it really is on me when I decide if I want to eat or not. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
You'll have a wonderful day. Go, Sandy. I'm not gonna be able to do anything tonight.
That was a lot of walking for you. Seeing my brother trying to do things for himself and being in so much pain, it really breaks my heart. Us watching him, my mom, my dad especially, it's heartbreaking. It's kind of devastating almost. All right, good night, bub.